So, where we last left off, we were about to face off against Erica, with a severely underleveled Beltan, with no type advantages. Let's see how this goes. Alright. Hello, Erica. I'm here to sweep you with just one tiny mythical Pokemon. Did she just fall asleep? Yes. How did you doze off standing up? Hello, Erica. The art of flower arranging. It's not that I hate making my Pokemon OP, it's that I don't like steamrolling through the game because it's less of an experience. But having one Pokemon be OP and still having a reasonably difficult time, I'm cool with that. Student of Art Flower Raging, I can see that. Pokemon are all grass types. Yes, I did. Yes, you will. I'm calling it now. Her highest level is 35. And headbutt. Eevee can't evolve in Let's Go Eevee. Nor can my Gigantamax Eevee evolve, so that won't work either. Actually, correction. Partner Eevee can't evolve in Let's Go Eevee. Was that sleep powder? Alright. Well, I'm just gonna fill my water while I get steamrolled here. We're gonna go for another headbutt. And I went from overpowered to completely underpowered in the span of a single battle. Someone get me a neck brace. I'm gonna get whiplash from this. I just realized, Meltan's tail is a coaxial cable. And did Tangela just heal up, or was that a Mega Drain? Get ready, chat. We're in this for the long haul. Oh yeah, Archer, be very careful not to typo that, because I also have auto swear prevention on the Streamlabs bot, so... I don't expect you to do it intentionally, just letting you know, do not fudge those keystrokes. Oh, hey, I just realized. I forgot to mod you. Nope, what is... and headbutt again. Darn it! That's what I get for not paying attention. Trying to mod someone in the middle of a stream and making it so I can't see the screen seems like a very bad idea in retrospect. Well, this Vulpix is about to get a ton of levels. Okay, good, that worked. For some reason, Twitch wasn't showing me your name with a capital B, so I was concerned I modded the wrong person. I don't need agility. It is time for Vulpix to sweep. Or not. Oh wait, it's part prototype, so it can't be poisoned. Gosh darn it. And tis I who will be swept. Don't know. And Caterpie. I do have a lot of spare time, but I also have a... Well, I have spare time from the regular work I have to do, but between this stream and yesterday's stream, I have, like, end stuff I had ongoing in the background already. I have, like, 10 videos I need to do. Or, like, edit. And editing is the most time-consuming part. Seriously, I'm only like a third of the way of editing the first Pokemon Sword stream. I want to start uploading again soon. I think my first video back will be in April. When was the last video I posted that wasn't the Australian food taste testing stuff? I think... No, not a year. It was like October. So, 5 months? And we have a Pharaoh. And Caterpie is evolving. Hold on, wait a minute. I didn't win, did I? Pokemon can still evolve when they're fainted? Huh. Alright. Second verse, better than the first. A little bit smarter and hopefully not worse. Alright, this time I'm going to go for the more optimal strategies. Which is Thunder Wave, then Headbutt. Alright, Erica, round two. And we have to go through this again. Thunder Wave right off the bat. Thunder Wave, and then I'm going to harden 6 times. Then heal up whenever I need to, and then I will be unstoppable. Mega Drain is an inconvenience so long as I don't damage you. Wish Meltan could learn Body Press in this. I could take one more as long as it doesn't crit. Should be the last one. Yes, there we go. Now, you begin having problems. Okay, that's a flinch. Okay, we avoid the sleep powder. Mega Drain, but that's fine. That was a crit. Excuse me. Mega Drain has what, 15 PP? Right, because Absorb has either 20 or 25. So Mega Drain has either 10 or 15, because I know Giga Drain has 5, and I'm asleep. Run out of Mega Drain. That would be incredibly good for me if it did. And we're going in for another headbutt. I think this next turn we're going to be freed from bind. Gosh darn it! Okay, just one more turn, and we're on to Weeping Bell, who is not going to be very effective against me. Oh boy, this is tough enough. Wait until I Nuzlocke this game. Because I don't know if I've mentioned it before, but I fully intend on Nuzlocking Let's Go Eevee once I beat the story at least once. Ooh, setting in Vileplume. Why does that keep happening? Oh dear. No, I need to heal. Like, now. It's not impossible, you just have to adapt the rules very specifically for it. So, like, obviously, if a Pokemon faints, it's dead thing, that's easy. The way I'm going to do it is, the first Pokemon you encounter on a route is the one you have to catch. But, since you're playing Let's Go, and you can see the Pokemon in the overworld and such, it actually makes it slightly easier, because you can weave around all the other Pokemon, and, like, go to a route where you've already caught something and build up catch combos. Just, the one restriction with that is, anything you catch that isn't the first on the route, you have to either immediately release or not use at all. And the reason I phrase it like that is because I'm... What the... Suffice it to say, I do have a way I'm going to go about it. And I'll be sure to write it down and go into that when I do. Alright, oh boy. And... Oh, we have one headbutt left. Okay. I can't believe I forgot to do this when Vileplume came out. Well, get ready, there's probably going to be a third verse. Alright, I have no choice but to use Thunderbolt. Can paralysis just work, please? Thank you. Finally, it ran out of Mega Drain. What would Moonblast have been good against? Psychic? No. Oh! That'll be a problem throughout the rest of the battle. I didn't know Moonblast dropped special attack. Uh-oh. Alright. So yeah, all that happened during the break was another Thunderbolt and another Moonblast. Should be good for now. Alright, Alright. So the problem I face right now is that I'm probably not going to have enough Thunderbolt to take down Weeping Bell. But if I switch out, I lose all of the hardens. Level 28. We're gonna keep going as long as we can. And immediately with a Thunder Wave. And of course, it has Mega Drain. That's 2. I think it has 15? Nope. Why did I do that? Okay, when Pokemon games just need to leave the cursor on the last thing selected, especially when it's not a touchscreen. Whatever, I'm just wasting time until it runs out of Mega Drains anyway. Just run out of Mega Drains already. Finally! And now I have to switch. Dang it, poison jab. Okay. Three ethers, four elixirs. Which one did what? Each of the moves. Alright. As much as this hurts! I still don't get it. Ethers and elixirs are clearly manufactured goods. Why can't you just buy them? Finally. Can we get Mega Drain? It's not wonderful when you're on the receiving end of it. All right, can I buy Ultra Balls? Yes! Hallelujah! Thank you very much, and I will see you next time.